Hello friends, in this lecture we will learn about ARP and RARP. What is ARP? ARP is Address Resolution Protocol, and Reverse ARP is again Reverse Address Resolution Protocol. So we will understand about it. So what happens is, when you are on a local area network, so we operate on two addresses for a host. One is your logical address, and for example IP address, and second we have physical address, which is MAC address of 6 bytes. So how to make a relationship between these two addresses? So if I know the IP address of machine and I want to know the physical address for it, I will use ARP. And if I know IP address and want to know physical, I will use RARP. These both ARP and RARP are there in a network layer protocol. What is ARP? ARP associates an IP address with its physical addresses on a typical physical network such as LAN. Each device on a link is identified by a physical or station address that is usually imprinted on the NIC. What is RARP? RARP finds the logical addresses for a machine that only knows its physical address. Let's take a simple network here. Here is a computer A and computer B. Let's say computer A needs to communicate computer B. How would it do that? First of all, it gonna try to find the IP address of B. Let must say uses DNS to try find IP address because it knows the name of computer B. So DNS server, hey, do you have an IP address for computer B? The DNS server returns the IP address. So now computer A knows computer B's IP address but doesn't know its MAC address or hardware address. So it can't communicate with it yet. And this is why ARP comes in. So computer A is gonna send an ARP request. An ARP request is broadcast. It's gonna say, hey, I know this IP address, what's the MAC address for? So it's gonna broadcast that out. And because of this broadcast, it's going to communicate to all host in broadcast domain, including computer B in this situation. Computer B gonna see this ARP request and say, that's my IP address, I know my MAC address, let me send my MAC address to you, computer A. And it's gonna send it. And now computer A is no MAC address and IP address of computer B. And now it can communicate directly with it. Next is Reverse Address Resolution Protocol, that is RARP. It was used for host computer that configured their own IP address, so they would actually send a reverse ARP request and say, hey, here is my MAC address, what's my IP address? So this finds an IP address from a MAC address. So it's the reverse of ARP.